strategic survivor here. The very last video of 2017. We started this experiment in August. It's December. And the first thing I want to say before I say anything else, thank you all so much. Whether it's the blog that you are reading, the email, newsletter that you're reacting to, or the videos that you're sharing, your reactions, your feedback, your comments have been beyond anything I could imagine. I hope this experiment is something that you can come back to, look through the videos, and get a little bit of inspiration, a little bit of support as you are trying to figure out how to ride the waves of change rather than being crushed by them. You are trying to figure out how to reinvent yourself and help your team, your daughter or parent, your friend, your company, your community react to the change in a way that is empowering, in a way that is positive and uplifting. That is what Chief Reinvention Officer is all about. It is our very last video, of course, and I want to take a few seconds to reflect on what is the most important thing that happened this year, and what's the one message I want to leave you as you are entering into 2018. For me, it has been a powerful experience traveling around the world, speaking quite a bit more on this topic, and trying to get this idea, the idea of reinvention being a habit, a way of life, a natural and very needed skill, the basic literacy skill of 21st century, spreading that gospel all around the world and helping schools, businesses, communities, politicians, companies, nonprofits reinvent themselves much better than they have done before. Very recently, I was in Bratislava. All of you joining us from Slovakia, thank you so much for a warm welcome. It was a few very intense days, and at the end of one day, I asked the executive what was the most important message he got out of it. And he said, well, I used to think reinvention is all about this radical, big, disruptive things. We were a cooling and heating company and became an automotive company. We were a TV company and now we're a medical company. What I got out of it is actually reinvention always comes in small steps. There's no really a big disruptive change. A big disruptive change is made of tiny little steps, the incremental daily things we do so that we are inching ourselves forward just a little bit. And that's the message I want to leave you in 2018. Start with small changes. Don't worry about anything big. Don't worry about disruption. Don't worry about the leaps into the future. Start with one little thing. Think about this year and think of one thing that you have reinvented in your life. It might be that you're drinking more water. It might be that you're calling your colleagues more often rather than just sending them text messages. It might be you started running your meetings differently, or you are summarizing the reports differently. It might be that you started talking to your clients more than you ever done before. It might be anything, but one thing. Choose one thing that you have reinvented in 2017. And then commit to one thing you will reinvent already in January of 2018. One experiment. You see, I'm very comfortable now in front of this camera, but if you look at my first videos, I was interrupting myself and kind of making sounds almost after each sentences. That was my big reinvention challenge, is to stand in front of camera and do these videos. I'm sure you've done something, and I'm sure you can do one experiment in 2018 already in January. So one thing you've done in 17, one thing you commit to in 2018. And the third assignment I have for you, the third way to commit to incremental rather than being obsessive around radical change, is to think about one thing you don't want to change. One thing you want to keep continuous, that you can preserve and protect, that you started in 2017, or maybe even before that. Maybe you have it since early childhood, or maybe you picked it up in college or in your first job. What is one thing you do not want to change? Here's the three things I'm asking you to commit to. Celebrate what you already reinvented in 2017. Commit to a reinvention experiment already in January of 2018. And protect one thing that you think should not be compromised, no matter what happens to you. That is my big message, the closing message of this year. This has been a wild ride. I'm sure we will reinvent something. Our team at Chief Reinvention Officer is working hard to come up with new ideas, new solutions, new support resources for you. So I'm sure you might be surprised, but we will come up with something that will reinvent even with this blog and video solution already early in 2018. But before that, I want to celebrate this moment. Thank you for taking your time. Thank you for giving a chance to yourself, because when you give a chance to yourself to let go of things that no longer serve you, to upgrade things that no longer support you, when you give yourself a chance to reinvent, you earn the right to choose who you want to be. And that is the most important choice, the most powerful choice you have. Every time you reinvent, you're choosing a new you. You're choosing a new company, you're choosing a new product, you're choosing a new life. So I appreciate the time you took this year, supporting yourself, supporting your company, your team, supporting your community, as you were exploring what are small, incremental, or big disruptive reinventions you want to pursue, because you were choosing a new version of yourself and of this world. I hope your 2018 is filled with joy and light. I hope it's full of beautiful choices. I hope you're leaving behind things that are weighing you down. I hope you take time to celebrate, call someone you care about, do something for yourself, do something for the world. We all need a touch of reinvention right now. Have an amazing, amazing holiday season and a glorious 2018. I see you very soon.